Seoul's foreign minister and Washington's top envoy to the United Nations have agreed to push for more powerful and independent sanctions against North Korea for its continual nuclear and missile provocations. On fresh multilateral sanctions by the UN Security Council, Samantha Power said the council will take its time to craft the best possible measures. Kwon Soa reports.
After wrapping up a meeting with U.S. Ambassador to the UN Samantha Power on Monday, South Korea's Foreign Minister Yoon Byung-se says Seoul and Washington are in talks of bringing up extra sanctions on North Korea.
Seoul and Washington are coordinating independent sanctions on various levels, which I also discussed with Ambassador Power today. South Korea's government is also examining much stronger independent sanctions than those imposed in March.
Minister Yoon added the EU and Japan are also working on independent sanctions and that such measures come at a timely moment as they will maximize the effects of other sanctions. The minister also deemed Ambassador Power's visit to South Korea as opportune as the UN Security Council is in deep talks on drafting a new set of sanctions on North Korea's fifth nuclear test last month. Ambassador Power told reporters that the UN Security Council is working around the clock to adopt a new resolution as quickly as possible. However,
"We are for a resolution that makes a substantive difference and changes the calculus over time of the North Korean leadership. So we are not going to sacrifice or shortchange our ambition to rush this out. We want this resolution to be practically impactful on the ground."
Regarding cooperation from China and Russia, two of the five permanent members of the UN Security Council, the UN envoy said the U.S. will exert all possible political influence to ensure support from all council members. Power also met with Unification Minister Hong Yong-pyo on the same day, emphasizing the importance of the work at the ministry, saying unification is what everyone wishes to see. She expressed her impression of her visit to the truce village of Panmunjeom on the inter-Korean border Sunday, where she felt how close the threat of nuclear and missile tests are, and also underscored the urgency of dealing with families separated since the Korean War. The ambassador returns to New York Tuesday, wrapping up a four-day trip to South Korea. Kwon Soa, Arirang News.